Imagine this, a humanoid robot that looks, moves, and talks just like a human. Always there when you need them, never arguing, never leaving. Sounds perfect, or does it? Humanoid companion robots are no longer just the stuff of science fiction. Around the world, engineers and designers are racing to create machines that could one day live in our homes, not as tools, but as partners. Some already have incredibly realistic faces, others can walk, gesture, and even mimic emotion. But here's the truth, no one has yet combined all of these capabilities into one fully functional being. Right now, the reality is fragmented. Aria has a lifelike presence but can't walk. Real Doll offers stunning realism in appearance but no motion. A head form creates faces so convincing you'd swear they were human, but there's no body. Tesla's Optimus can walk and lift, but looks purely utilitarian. So the question isn't could you buy one today? It's what would it mean when you can? Think about the implications. Would a humanoid companion blur the lines between human and machine relationships? Who owns the rights to their personality? You, or the company that made them? And what happens when AI inside that robot starts making its own decisions? There's also the question of cost. Right now, the closest thing to a fully realistic humanoid could set you back more than $175,000, and that's without full mobility or sentience. Early adopters will face not only technical limitations, but also society's judgment. Are you a pioneer or crossing a line? The future of humanoid companions is both exciting and unsettling. They could help the elderly, assist people with disabilities, or provide comfort to the lonely. But they could also raise profound moral questions about consent, autonomy, and what it means to be human in an age when machines can mimic us so well. So, before you say I'd want one, think about what that truly means. Are you ready to live with a being that's almost human, but not quite? Humanoid robots are closer than ever, but they're not perfect, and they're certainly not magic. The question isn't just whether you could buy one. It's whether you should. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Would you welcome a humanoid companion into your home and life? Or is this a step too far?